Have you ever wondered how a hacker could break into a highly secure system without writing a single line of code? Welcome to the fascinating world of social engineering, where the weakest link in cybersecurity isn't a computer, but the person sitting in front of it. In this video, we're going to unravel the psychology behind social engineering and explore how these master manipulators exploit human nature to bypass even the most sophisticated security measures. Let's start with a scenario. Imagine you're working in a busy office. The phone rings and the caller introduces himself as John from IT support. He says there's been a security breach and he needs your login credentials to check if your account was compromised. Would you give him your password? If you hesitated, good. If you said yes, don't worry, you're not alone. This is a classic social engineering attack, and it preys on our natural inclination to trust and help others. Social engineering is the art of manipulating people into giving up confidential information or taking actions that compromise security. Unlike traditional hacking methods that exploit technical vulnerabilities, social engineering targets the human element, which is often the weakest link in any security chain. Now let's dive deeper into some common social engineering tactics. First, we have pretexting. This involves creating a fabricated scenario to obtain information. An attacker might call your company's HR department, posing as a senior executive needing urgent access to employee records. By sounding authoritative and pressured, they might convince HR to email sensitive data. Next, there's baiting. Think of this as the digital equivalent of leaving a tempting trap. An attacker might create a website offering free movie downloads. When users try to download a film, they instead install malware on their computers. Now, let's talk about quid pro quo attacks. These promise a benefit in exchange for information. An attacker might email employees claiming to be from the IT department, offering a free software upgrade. In reality, they're installing a backdoor into the company's network. Another tactic is tailgating, a physical social engineering method. Picture this: an attacker, dressed in a suit and carrying a stack of pizza boxes, approaches a secure entrance. An employee holds the door open, assuming they're a legitimate delivery person. Just like that, physical security is bypassed. But why do these tactics work so well? The answer lies in human psychology. Social engineers are expert manipulators who exploit cognitive biases we all have. For instance, they use the authority bias, our tendency to obey figures of authority. When someone claims to be from IT or management, we're more likely to comply with their requests without question. They also leverage the scarcity bias, which makes us value things that are rare or time-sensitive. That's why phishing emails often create a sense of urgency, claiming your account will be closed if you don't act immediately. Another powerful tool in their arsenal is the social proof phenomenon. We tend to follow the actions of others, assuming they know something we don't. That's why some attacks involve creating fake reviews or testimonials to lend credibility to their schemes. So, how can we protect ourselves and our organizations from these psychological tricks? First and foremost, education is key. Understanding these tactics helps us recognize them in action. Organizations should invest in regular training sessions to keep employees informed about the latest social engineering threats. Next, it's crucial to implement and follow verification procedures. If someone requests sensitive information, there should be a process to confirm their identity, even if they claim to be in a position of authority. This might involve calling them back on a known number or verifying their request through a separate channel. Now, let's talk about cultivating a security-minded culture. This means encouraging people to question unusual requests and report suspicious activities without fear of reprimand. Remember, it's better to double-check than to fall victim to an attack. Another important step is to use technology wisely. While social engineering targets humans, technology can still play a crucial role in defense. Email filters can catch many phishing attempts, and two-factor authentication can prevent unauthorized access, even if credentials are compromised. Lastly, and perhaps most importantly, we need to foster a healthy dose of skepticism. This doesn't mean becoming paranoid, but rather developing a habit of critical thinking. If something seems too good to be true, or if an urgent request doesn't feel quite right, trust your instincts and verify. As we wrap up, let's remember that social engineering is a powerful reminder that security isn't just about firewalls and encryption. It's about people. By understanding how attackers exploit human nature, we can build more comprehensive and effective security strategies. In our interconnected world, each of us plays a role in maintaining cybersecurity. So the next time you receive an unexpected email asking for sensitive information, or a stranger tries to tailgate you into a secure area, pause and think. That moment of hesitation could be the difference between security and a successful social engineering attack. In our next video, we'll explore another captivating concept in the world of ethical hacking. Until then, stay curious, stay skeptical, and above all, stay secure. Because in the game of cybersecurity, the best defense is an informed and vigilant human.